The Rothschild Collection, a legacy of art and power. In the late 18th century, a young Mayor Amschel Rothschild laid the foundations for one of the most influential and enigmatic families in history. Born in 1744 in the Jewish ghetto of Frankfurt, Germany, Mayor Amschel was the son of a money changer and a merchant. He learned the art of finance and trade from his father and quickly proved himself to be a shrewd businessman. Mayor Amschel's big break came when he was appointed as the financial agent for the Elector of Hesse, a German nobleman. This position allowed him to build relationships with European royalty and nobility, establishing the Rothschild family as a major force in international finance. As Mayor Amschel's wealth and influence grew, so did his passion for collecting art and antiques. He began to acquire rare coins, medals, and other historical artifacts, laying the foundation for the Rothschild collection. Mayor Amschel's sons, Amschel, Solomon, Nathan, Kalman, and Jakob, were all involved in the family business and shared their father's passion for collecting. They scoured Europe for rare and valuable items, often using their financial connections to acquire pieces that others could not. One of the earliest and most significant pieces in the Rothschild collection is a rare 16th-century German astronomical clock. This intricate timepiece, made by the renowned clockmaker, Jost Berge, is a testament to the Rothschilds' commitment to preserving the art and science of the past. As the Rothschild brothers expanded their financial empire, they also expanded their collecting habits. They developed a keen eye for art and antiques, often seeking out rare and unusual pieces. Amschel, the eldest brother, was particularly fond of collecting rare books and manuscripts. He amassed an impressive collection of works by famous authors and philosophers, including a rare first edition of Newton's Principia Mathematica. Solomon, on the other hand, was fascinated by art. He collected works by European masters, including Rembrandt, Rubens, and Velázquez. His collection also included an impressive array of sculptures, including works by Michelangelo and Bernini. Nathan, the most business-savvy of the brothers, focused on collecting rare coins and medals. He amassed an impressive collection of ancient Greek and Roman coins, as well as medals commemorating significant historical events. The Rothschilds were not only collectors but also patrons of the arts. They supported emerging artists and commissioned works from established masters. One notable example is the Rothschilds' patronage of the artist, Jacques-Louis David. They commissioned several works from him, including a portrait of Mayor Amschel's son, Nathan. The Rothschilds also supported the development of the arts in their communities. They funded the construction of theaters, concert halls, and museums, and sponsored cultural events and exhibitions. The 19th century, a time of expansion underscore. The 19th century was a time of great expansion for the Rothschild family. They continued to build their financial empire, and their collecting habits became even more sophisticated. We take a rare glimpse into the treasures of the Rothschild collection. From the stunning Rothschild Fabergé egg to the magnificent Rothschild pearl necklace, we explore some of the most exquisite pieces in the collection. Created by Peter Carl Fabergé, this stunning egg is one of the most famous in the world. Adorned with gold, silver, and precious gems, it is a masterpiece of Russian craftsmanship. September 2, 1804, Napoleon Bonaparte, Emperor of France, presented a ceremonial sword to Marshal Louis-Alexander Berthier, his chief of staff. This sword, with its intricate designs and symbols, would later become one of the most prized possessions of the Rothschild family. The sword features an illuminating prayer, a unique mechanism that reveals a hidden message when held up to the light. The message reads, "Dieu protège la France," God protects France. The illuminating prayer works through a clever use of optics and design. The sword's blade is etched with tiny holes, forming the shape of the message. When held up to the light, the holes allow the light to pass through, illuminating the message on the surface below. The Rothschilds acquired the sword in the late 19th century, and it has been a treasured family heirloom ever since. Its significance extends beyond its historical importance, symbolizing the Rothschilds' connection to European history and their commitment to preserving cultural heritage. The Napoleon sword serves as a poignant reminder of the Rothschilds' legacy, a testament to their enduring passion for collecting and preserving the world's most extraordinary treasures. This exquisite necklace features 38 natural pearls, each one perfectly matched for size and color. It is a testament to the Rothschilds' love of rare and beautiful jewelry, include some of the most impressive works of art and antiques in Europe. They acquired rare paintings, sculptures, and furniture, as well as extensive collections of rare books, manuscripts, and coins. The Rothschild Collection is a legacy of beauty, a testament to the family's enduring passion for art, antiques, and rare objects. Baron James de Rothschild, the youngest son of Mayor Amschel, was perhaps the most passionate collector of the family. He amassed an incredible collection of art and antiques, including works by Rembrandt, Vermeer, and Rubens. Baron James was particularly fond of collecting rare porcelain and ceramics. His collection included some of the finest examples of Chinese porcelain in Europe, as well as an impressive array of European ceramics. As the Rothschilds' collections grew, they needed more space to display and store their treasures. They built magnificent country estates throughout Europe, each designed to showcase their collections. Waddesdon Manor in England, built by Baron Ferdinand de Rothschild, is a prime example. This stunning estate features an impressive collection of art and antiques, including works by Rembrandt, Rubens, and Velázquez. The Rothschilds were avid collectors of rare books and manuscripts. They sought out first editions, limited prints, and works of historical significance. Baron Lionel de Rothschild's collection of rare books was particularly impressive. He acquired works such as the Gutenberg Bible and the Bay Psalm Book, two of the rarest books in the world. The Rothschilds were also passionate collectors of porcelain. They acquired some of the finest examples of Chinese, Japanese, and European porcelain, including rare pieces from the Ming Dynasty. Baron James de Rothschild's collection of porcelain was renowned for its beauty and rarity. He acquired pieces such as the famous Rothschild vase, a rare Chinese porcelain vase from the Qing Dynasty. The Rothschilds were not only collectors but also patrons of the arts. Baron Mayer de Rothschild commissioned the famous artist, Jean-Hippolyte Flandrin, to paint a portrait of his wife, Baroness Betty de Rothschild. The late 19th and early 20th centuries were a time of great opulence for the Rothschild family. They continued to build their collections, and their love of art, antiques, and rare books only grew stronger. The Rothschilds' country estates became centers of culture, hosting lavish parties and gatherings for the elite. Waddesdon Manor, built by Baron Ferdinand de Rothschild, was a prime example. Waddesdon Manor featured an impressive collection of art and antiques, including works by Rembrandt, Rubens, and Velázquez. The estate also boasted an extensive library, a wine cellar, and a beautiful garden. The Rothschilds were also known for their exquisite jewelry collection. They acquired rare pieces from famous jewelers like Cartier and Tiffany. Baroness Betty de Rothschild's collection of jewelry was particularly impressive. She owned pieces such as the famous Rothschild pearl necklace, a stunning necklace featuring 38 natural pearls. The Rothschilds were not only collectors but also philanthropists. They supported various causes, including education, healthcare, and the arts. Baron Edmund de Rothschild was a notable philanthropist, supporting the establishment of the Hebrew University of Jerusalem and the Jewish Museum in Berlin. LL. World War I marked a turning point for the Rothschild family. Many of their country estates and collections were threatened by the war. The Rothschilds played an important role in the war effort, with some family members serving in the military and others supporting the Red Cross. Despite their efforts, the Rothschilds suffered significant losses during the war. Many of their country estates were damaged or destroyed, and some of their collections were looted or lost. The Rothschilds' Parisian mansion, for example, was occupied by German forces during the war. Many of the artworks and antiques were removed or destroyed. After the war, the Rothschilds worked to rebuild and restore their collections. They also continued to support the arts and philanthropic causes. Baron Henri de Rothschild, for example, was a prominent supporter of the arts, and his collection of modern art was renowned. The Rothschild family's legacy extends far beyond their collections. They played a significant role in shaping European history, finance, and culture. Their commitment to philanthropy and the arts continues to inspire new generations. The 20th century brought significant changes to the Rothschild family. Many of their traditional sources of income, such as banking and finance, began to decline. However, the Rothschilds adapted and evolved, investing in new industries and ventures. Today, the Rothschild family continues to collect and support the arts. Their contemporary collections feature works by living artists, as well as cutting-edge installations and exhibitions. The Rothschilds also continue to support philanthropic causes, with a focus on education, healthcare, and the environment. The Rothschild Foundation, established by Baron Jacob Rothschild, supports a wide range of philanthropic causes. The foundation focuses on education, arts, and culture, as well as social welfare and environmental issues. The Rothschild Collection is a testament to the family's enduring legacy. With its vast array of art, antiques, and rare books, the collection continues to inspire and educate new generations. As the Rothschild family looks to the future, they remain committed to preserving their heritage while embracing new challenges and opportunities. Today, the Rothschild Collection is a global presence, with artworks and artifacts housed in museums and estates around the world. From Waddesdon Manor in England to the Rothschild Estate in France, the collection is a testament to the family's enduring legacy. The Rothschild Collection continues to be a source of inspiration for artists, curators, and collectors. The collection's vast array of art, antiques, and rare books provides a unique window into the past, while also informing contemporary culture. The Rothschild family remains committed to preserving and protecting the collection for future generations. Through their philanthropic efforts and support of the arts, the Rothschilds ensure that the collection continues to inspire and educate. As the Rothschild Collection looks to the future, it is clear that the family's legacy will endure. With its global presence, diverse holdings, and commitment to philanthropy, the Rothschild Collection will continue to inspire and educate for generations to come. The Rothschild Collection is a legacy of beauty, a testament to the family's enduring passion for art, antiques, and rare objects. Through this video, we hope to inspire a new appreciation for the collection and its significance in the world of art and culture.